One of the definitions of dendrite is a crystal or crystalline mass with branching tree-like structure. When you put paint between two rigid surfaces and apply pressure, you get dendritic-like effects, creating that branching structure that looks like a branch or coral. In today's video, I'm using our clear acrylic stamp mounts to put pressure on paint and create dendritic prints. There have been a number of videos produced about creating dendritic prints, most of them a few years ago, where others have experimented with the process, which is actually pretty straightforward. You're going to put paint between two layers of something, and we'll talk about that in a second, press them together, and then when you lift that top piece off, it's going to reveal the patterning that gets created. What I'm demoing today is just my process with a twist here and there. Now, most folks who create these prints, or at least what I've seen, are using glass. But the problem with glass is especially glass that you might get from an inexpensive picture frame, is that it's thin enough that if you press hard enough, you're liable to snap it, which nobody wants. So instead, I'm using our acrylic stamp mounts. They're available in a lot of sizes. This is 4x4, this is 7x7, and they're very, very sturdy, so you're not going to break them. You all know I love sparkly and metallic paint, so for today I'm working with Finnebert's Art Alchemy, and I'm working with Viva Decor's Precious Metal Paint. We have this on clearance, we've got colors left, it's still 50% off, and as it happens, the Finnebert Art Alchemy is on sale at 25% off now. So with that said, when you put paint on the acrylic mount, the shape that you apply the paint in is going to some degree affect the outcome, which is how I ended up with shapes like this. I don't know if I could duplicate it, but I know it's how I ended up with shapes like that. So what I'm going to do is also show you the next thing. When you put paint between glass or acrylic, there's a tendency for them to want to hold on to one another, and separating them can be a problem. So what I've discovered is, and I'm going to exaggerate this, if I offset these like this, now I've kind of got built-in handles that I can grab when it comes time to separate them. So I'm going to use some of the Art Alchemy. This is one of the Sparks colors, and I'm just going to put a little bit down here. Doesn't require very much. Wipe off my palette knife. Oh, and by the way, lots of folks who do this, they'll brush the paint out with a paintbrush. I'm way too lazy to clean brushes, so I just use a palette knife and kind of spread it out. All right. So that's ready to go. Now I'm going to put the top piece on, but remembering to offset it a little bit so I can grab those pieces. Now, as I start to push, the paint's going to start to move. You can see that it was thinner here, and you can already see the tendrils starting to form. Where the paint is thicker is where you're going to get bigger branches. They're going to be less fine, I guess, is a way to describe it. So since I don't want big blobby looks, I'm going to push this out pretty far to create some thinner tendrils. Now what I'm going to do is pick this up, and I'm going to use that little handle I built in for myself, and I'm going to start separating these, which I can assure you is hard to do holding up like this. But you can see now that I've got these pieces, or sorry, these prints ready to pull. So I'm just going to put some paper on here, and you can almost, this is inexpensive printer paper, you can almost see the color of the paint through it. You want to be careful. If you press too hard, you're going to smush the tendrils, and you're not going to get, how pretty is that? You're not going to get a nice fine print. You can't dawdle, especially as it's fall now, and here in Rhode Island, the heat is starting to run every now and then, and things dry out quickly, so you don't want to wait too long. But again, I love this really, really delicate look that you get by forcing that paint out. All right, so I'm going to just spray these with water. And then I'm going to bring in the larger 7x7 plate, and I want to show you using the precious metal color. It's my bottom piece. Grab some of this pink. So there's a mixing ball in here that you might not be able to hear, but I shook this pretty well a moment ago, so I'm not going to shake it too much now. And I'm just going to go ahead. Now this is a thinner bodied paint, but I'm just going to go ahead and spread this out. And if there's a gap, there's liable to be a gap when I pull the print, because I'm only going to be able to push that paint so far. Again, I'm going to remember to offset it. I'm going to put it down and start pressing. Now I can drive the paint one way or the other, but the initial shape is definitely going to affect the outcome of your final dendritic shape and whatever you pull as a print. What I'm doing, I'm using my right hand to hold these together, and then I'm using my left hand now to push these apart, because if you're not careful, it's easy to make this twist when you do this. Been there, done that, got the t-shirt, don't want it again. All right, so I think this is good. Again, I'm gonna lift this up. I'm gonna use kind of my built-in handles, and you can see it's already started to separate again. And let's print. I think that when you create elements like this, it suggests backgrounds for you. I think this looks like coral. In fact, it looks like a coral formation, not just because of the branches, but because of the overall shape. How pretty is that? Isn't that awesome? And of course, you've got all that shine and all that glimmer from the mica that's in the precious metal paint. It's actually a little more intense than the Art Alchemy paint is. But I've got bigger branches here because I didn't push it quite as far apart. So when you look at these two, you can see the difference. Fine, fine tendrils like this are a result of really pushing that paint out and forcing it as far apart as possible. Next, I'm going to look at combining colors and printing on things like Smooth and Sturdy or our white watercolor paper. As I said at the end of the last segment, all of the previous demos were printed on inexpensive copy paper, which is really lightweight and allows you to see a little bit about where the paint has already transferred. But because metallic colors look so darn good on black, it's worth it to figure out how to do this in such a way so that you can capture this and not press too hard. So it requires a little bit of fiddling like some things do. So again, two colors of Art Alchemy paint. This time, I'm going to let them blend a little bit. So there's my top piece. Clean that off and come in with some of the pink. All right, let's see what happens. Push these out of the way. Put my top piece on and offset it and start to press. And you can see that I'm getting some blending of colors, and I'm going to push these hard because I want to spread this way out so that I get nice fine tendrils. And you can see that I'm driving the paint this way with the pressure from my thumb. I don't want this to take forever, but I do want to get some nice fine branches, so I am going to just take the time to push on this and make certain it's spread out. And I can see that I'm already getting some fine branches forming. All right, so I think that's good enough. Let me lift this up and start to separate. Okay. So when you do this with a heavier paper like this, I find that the best thing that I can do is gently place it where I want it to be, and then I'm just lightly tapping with my fingers, just enough to try to get that paper to touch the surface of the paint where it's raised in those shapes, but not smush. You can rub really lightly like this. I mean, it's just a feather light touch at this point. All right, we pick this up. Oh, how pretty is that? Isn't that awesome? So let's print this one quickly before it dries to the point where it won't. Again, I'm going to just touch ever so lightly, just enough to get that the other side of the black Smooth and Sturdy page to touch the paint. Oh, see? So pretty. Okay, so let's quickly clean this up, because the last thing I want to show you is what happens when you are thoughtful about how you place your paint, and rather than having it run together like this, it's going to stay as dots. That's my plan for the next demo. So let's clean this off. Now, something worth noting, I am not the neatest person in the world. One look at my studio, if I actually let you see it, would confirm that, because there's stuff everywhere, because I'm always working on things. With that said, if you find that you haven't cleaned as well as you thought, and you get a little bit of an accumulation of paint on here, use some isopropyl alcohol, preferably the 91%, and it will clean a lot of that debris off for you. Okay, so dots. This time I'm going to print on, this is one of our 6x6 disc-bound watercolor pages, so I'm going to print on this. But I'm going to just do dots this time, and I'm going to make an effort to keep them small so that they stay as circles. So with that in mind, I'm just going to randomly put some paint down. No, I'm not going to do a ton of this because I don't want to be here all day, and there's only so much of this that you can watch. Then you lose the will to live because I'm doing the same thing over and over, and nobody needs that. So these are mostly round, and that's what I'm going to get, is mostly round when it comes time to squish these together and print. Let's just put a little bit of turquoise in. Now some of these are going to run together because the dots are reasonably close together, but as you experiment and play, you'll figure out how that works. All right. Let's offset and then just press. Now you can see those dots kind of form on their own. Again, because I like really thin tendrils, I'm going to press reasonably hard on this so that I get the paint to spread, which is going to give me those nice tiny tendrils. If you want thicker, then obviously you don't do this. You just kind of press a little bit more gently. And my suggestion is always is that you experiment until you find what works best for you and until you find what the process is that gives you outcomes that you really like. All right, so let's lift this up and then go ahead and print. I slid that, so we'll see what happens. Maybe it hadn't started to touch the paint yet. We'll find out in a moment. Again, really, really light touch. And then let's lift this. Oh, that worked out okay. So let's do this last one on black because I think that the metallic paint on the black is such a striking look. Again, really, really light touch. And let's pick that up. Oh, okay, so that worked too. And what you get is a mirror image when you, let's get this out of the way and pull this up where you can see it. When you create, because pulling these apart creates a mirror image, obviously when you print, you get that same mirror image. So whether you see tree branches, or you see coral, or you see whatever it is that you see, I think that this process is a lot of fun. It creates some really interesting effects, and what it does is it gives you fodder for all kinds of creative projects.